Hi friends, welcome to Tutor's Funny channel. Today I'm going to teach what's the difference between function and arrow function. How to create the function? Here I have first I have declaring the function keyword. After that, function name. Okay, I have given as my test one. This is the function name. Inside the function, I have written the console log test function work. Right, I just print out this. Text, right? So I just comment it. Let me run the application and check how the output. Here nothing will be printed. Why it nothing will be printed here is because when you write the function, you have to call them. So I have to call below. Now if you look at the output, test function is working. This is a simple function. This is how we have create the function. Function name. You have to print out the what you have to print. You have to given here. After that, you have to call the function. Right. Next, let me look at the example of this. This is the parameters I have passed inside the function. Right. Function name. I have. Given here as my test, I have given a three parameters: name, course, and age. I have print out line by line, name, course, and age. So here I have given the parameters look like this. Here my test is a function name. I have given here as John is a name, Node.js a course, age. If you are given like this, it goes to the particular parameter you have set it here, and here print out the value like this. Okay, now let's execute the program and check. Here first it will be printed as first things, this one. Second we print out the John, second Node.js, after that age will be printed. This is a simple example, right? The function example, simple example, right? Okay, this is a normal function. I'm not teaching arrow function yet, and I'll be teaching the arrow function just few minutes, right? Right. After that, you can see another example. The same example I am going to call it here. Here I am going to create the variable var. Here you can give any name. My test fn equal likewise. So now what happens is now you have to change here is Peter Java 25. So here the complete function I am put into one variable here, right? So it's very simple. So if you have print out what is the output given here, the same variable I just called here, right? So what you have to do the output. So you can see here the Peter Java 25, it print out. So here this all the things I have put into this simple variable, right? So the same thing we have to do the arrow function as well. So it's very simple. You can, instead of writing like this, it's very simple. So arrow function, what you have mentioned here, I no need this function keyword and function name, we no need. So instead of that, we have to remove that. So you have to put the this keyword. This is the arrow function. This is how the arrow function works, right? So let's remove all and check it here. The arrow function. Very simple. This is how the simple you write the arrow function. Now we let me run and check. Here Peter Java 25 has been printed out. So here look like this. Here again I am going to teach how to write this one. So here. Okay. See, this is a function name. I no need this to the function keyword, we no need. So let's remove it. Function name we no need, remove it. Instead of that, we have write this simple. That's it. Now let's run and check. You can get the printout like this. Peter Java 25. This is the printout you can give. Peter Java 25. This is a printout you can give. This is simple example of arrow function. It's very easy. You can give here, this is the meaning of error function. Error function. Function. Function in JavaScript. If you are not aware about this one, you must learn this one. This is very important stuff in your future example in JavaScript, right? Thank you for watching. We will meet another good example in the next video. Thank you for watching.